no hear Atta Halilintar? Do you guys know Atta Halilintar?
YouTuber.
Yes. The famous YouTuber in Indonesia, right? Now, about Atta Halilintar, do you know in which rank is he right now among the other YouTuber? Hello.
Yes, sorry, Mister. I cannot hear your voice.
What about now?
Yes,
can you hear me now?
Ah,
yeah. Okay.
Yes.
So yeah, Atta Halilintar is actually the first rank YouTuber in Indonesia. He has like 26 million followers or subscribers. And do you know who is the second rank? The second rank YouTuber in Indonesia. Anybody knows? No?
Maybe Ria Ricis.
Ria Ricis, exactly Ria Ricis. Atta Halilintar and then Ria Ricis. Do you know what is their salary in 1 month? The salary of Atta Halilintar and Ria Ricis in just 1 month?
Like, so much.
Exactly. Either 2 or 3 billion. 2 or 3 billion means 2 atau 3 miliar per month.
Yeah,
yeah, per month. Right. Anybody know what is the background educational background of Atta Halilintar? Anybody know the educational background of Atta Halilintar? Do you think Atta Halilintar is graduated from university or senior high school?
No.
From senior high school, yeah. If I'm mistaken, yeah. Right. What about Raffi Ahmad? Do you know Raffi Ahmad? Right?
Yes.
Okay. Raffi Ahmad, do you think he is graduated from university or not? Nugraha.
No. Just near high school.
Yeah. Do you think so also, Nugraha? Nugraha, can you hear me?
No.
Yeah. So, do you think Raffi Ahmad is graduated from university or senior high school? You don't know?
I don't know, sir.
You don't know. Yeah. What about you, Salsa? Do you know, Salsa? Salsa, can you hear me?
I know.
Yeah.
Raffi Ahmad.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, do you think he's graduated from senior high school or university? Raffi Ahmad.
Ya? University?
No. No, senior high school only.
Yes, senior high school.
Junior high school.
Senior high school only.
Senior high school.
Raffi Ahmad, right? But even if they are actually only graduated from senior high school, they have a lot of money, right? When they are joining entertainment industry, when they're becoming an artist, when they're becoming a YouTuber. As long as you get inside entertainment and industry, then you're going to get a lot of money. Let me ask you this. Umami, you are still university student, right?
No.
What? Housewife?
Huh?
What is your educational background right now?
Just senior high school.
Senior high school, okay. Senior high school. And then Nugraha, you are still university student, right?
Yeah.
Which semester are you now?
Semester
1, 2, 1, 1, 3. Okay, one. First semester. What about Salsa? In which semester are you now?
Fifth semester.
All right, fifth semester.
Yes.
Okay. Now, for example, Umami, after you graduated from senior high school, do you think you want to go to university, Umami?
Yes.
Why? Why do you want to go to university?
Because maybe in a modern time, I think it's are not enough if you are just only graduate from senior high school.
Why?
Maybe if you are graduate university, mm-hmm. you can have a chance mm-hmm. to be to get a better job than a senior high school.
All right. So basically, by having university,
and then maybe when mm-hmm. and maybe when you graduate university, mm-hmm. You can have so many experience, and then you can learn. Mm-hmm. Apa ya? Lebih dalam lagi gitu, maksudnya belajarnya deeper. Tuh bisa.
You can learn deeper, right? So that your hello?
Yes, I think my
that your graduation certificate from the university you can use it to find a job, right? And then from that job. You can get a lot of money, right? Hello? Teammate.
Mister.
Yeah. Can you hear me now? Guys, can you hear me?
Hello, mister.
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yes, mister.
Yeah. My internet connection is not really that good, sorry. So... Yeah. My voice is kind of breaking here. My voice. Sometimes you can hear my voice, sometimes you cannot hear my voice. Is it?
Like yes, that? Betul. Yes. Oh. Sometimes I can bad connection.
Yeah, I think so. Okay. Nah, good. Hello, can you hear me now?
Yes, mister.
Sorry for the internet connection problem. It keeps on happening like this. Okay, yeah. Continue again, yeah? Okay, so we are talking about, you joined the university because you want to get a job so that from that job you can get money, right?
Yes.
Oh, money. Okay. Is that your son, Salsa? Is that your child, Salsa?
Hmm?
Is that your son? Or your little sibling, your little sister, right?
Yes.
Okay. And now let's. Okay, sister. All right. So, Nugraha, what do you expect you are going to get after you graduated from university? What do you think you are going to get after you graduated from university? Do you think you can get a lot of money? When you have already graduated from university?
Maybe so.
Yes. You want to get a job from big company, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. So that from that big job, you can get a lot of money, right? From the city. Yeah. Okay. Now, it's going to be the question for all of you guys, for Umami and also for Nugraha and also for Salsa as well. Since the reasons on why you want to have high educations is so that you can get a job, so that after you get a job, you can get a lot of money. Then what about if the question is, for example, There is this producer from production house, from Sinetron, for example. They are trying to offer you to become an artist, to play in their Sinetron, for example. so that you will be able to become an artist in this sinetron. But the consequence is, for example, you will have to focus all of your time to play in this sinetron every day from morning until night, so that you wouldn't be able to go to university at all. So maybe you have to quit from your university. Do you think you will going to accept the offer or you are going to reject the offer? Nugraha. So what are you going to do? If there's this offer coming from big production house, offer you to become an artist, which have a lot of money, and this opportunity will not going to come to you twice. Do you think you are going to reject the offer or you are going to accept the offer? What do you think?
Reject, sir.
Reject? Why?
Yeah.
Why you want to reject?
Because
education is more important.
Yeah.
Why? Why education is important? So that you can get a job, right?
Maybe.
And after you get the job, you can get money, right?
Yeah.
Do you think the money that you get from the job will be able to compete with the money that Raffi Ahmad as an artist get? If you become an artist like Raffi Ahmad or maybe Atta Halilintar, you can get same amount of money.
No.
Why do you think no? Why do you say no? Because if the end goal of your having education is so that you can get a job, so that you can get the money, then why bother to have higher education? If, for example, there is offer offering you to become an artist with a lot of money, for example, do you think the amount of money that is enjoyed by Atta Halilintar, 3 million, 3 miliar, 3 billion, 3 miliar per bulan, do you think in all of your life, do you think you can get that money if you are working in a company? 3 billion rupiah, 3 miliar rupiah. Let's say not all year, maybe like 10 months, 10 years. Do you think you can get that a lot of money in 10 years? 3 miliar if you are working just in a company? Do you think you can do that? No?
No, sir.
No? Maybe say you will only going to get, I don't know, 3 million maybe only 5 million, maybe only 10 million, right? In 1 month.
Yeah.
In a big company, maybe you're going to get 10 million or above. In average company, you're going to get maybe 5 million. In a lower company, maybe you're going to get maybe 3 million.
Yeah.
But if you're becoming an artist, 3 billion, 3 miliar, or at least maybe 1 billion, 1 miliar, maybe that's going to be the amount of money that you're going to get in 1 month. if the end of your goal is to get money, then if you have the opportunity to become an artist, why you still choose education? So you're going to still choose education or to become an artist? If there is an offer coming from TV stations to offer you to become an artist. So, what do you think, Nugraha? Do you still want to continue your education? Are you sure you do want to become an artist and get a lot of money that you wouldn't be able to get if you're only working in a company? Which one you are going to choose, Nugraha? Artist or education?
Education, sir.
So it is okay, even though maybe your money is not a lot?
Yeah, it's okay, sir.
Why? Okay, maybe we can skip it. Now let's go to Umami. Umami?
Why not? I accept it.
Why?
Why not, mister? I will be accept it. Because it's a great opportunity.
All right.
Yeah.
Do you think you
it's a great opportunity for me.
Do you think you are going to
because long time ago, long time ago, honestly, I want to be an artist because okay. I like acting.
And then?
But it's just a dream.
Why not? Everything starts from dream, you know?
Because I never get offering to be an artist. So if there is producer and it, offering me to be an artist, maybe I accept it. Why not?
And you don't care about education, yeah?
No. Kan kalau belajar bisa di mana aja.
We can learn from you everywhere. Can get, you can learn yeah, from everywhere, okay. Right?
Maybe when you to be an artist, you can be an you can be an influencer.
Okay.
And then you can get you can start everything.
Hmm. All right. All right.
Because maybe because you have much money.
Okay.
And, this is great opportunity for me.
Of course, of course. Okay. What about you, Salsa?
Tentang apa ya, Mister? I think I'm forget.
You want to become an artist or then to choose education?
I like artist art now.
You want to become an artist or you want to continue your education? If there is TV station offering you to become an artist, do you think you are going to accept that? Elsa, what do you think? Do you think you want to become an artist? If there is TV station offer you to become an artist? Yes or no, Salsa?
Yes. Yes or no.
Why?
I'm confused.
All right, all right. Okay, now let's continue the question again. Now let's talk to Umami again. Can you name some of the artists who have, who doesn't have, who have high education?
Agnes Monica.
Who else?
Agnes Monica.
Only Agnes.
Cinta Laura.
And then?
Tasya Kamila. Higher education, yes.
Higher, not higher.
Higher, higher education.
Maudie Ayunda?
Yes, Maudie Ayunda.
Okay, let's see. Do you think which one they prioritize first? They build their career in the entertainment world first or they build their education first?
Their education first.
They build what?
Career is just selingan apa tuh, mister?
For example, like Mayu Maudi Ayunda, right?
Yes.
What is she doing right now? Is she still having university degree in Stanford right now, if I'm not mistaken?
Yes.
She's not yet graduated, right?
Yes.
So right now she's still studying in Stanford.
Yes.
But before she's studying in Stanford, after graduating from senior high school, she focused her career first, right? In the movie
yes.
and also entertainment industry, right?
Yes, mister.
So it means Maudie Ayunda prioritized the her career first in the entertainment industry. And then after her career become established and stable, then she choose to continue her education. Do you think the same also with Cinta Laura, right?
Yes, is there.
Build the career first when there is opportunity, and then after the career has suddenly been stable, and then they can choose any kind of a university that they want with a lot of money that they have, right?
Maybe that's mean both is their priority.
Yeah, they can achieve both, but they have to prioritize which one they have to do first.
And yes, Mr.
For example, career in the entertainment industry will not going to come to you twice, right? This kind of opportunity, so that they will going to get that first after they have already established their career in the entertainment world, and then they move on with their higher education, right?
Yes, Mr. Actually, because he have a good planning. So,
do you think all of most of artists also have a thinking like Cinta Laura, Maudy Ayunda, and Tasha Kamila?
After maybe not, Mister.
Maybe not. Not all of them want to continue their higher education, right?
Yes, Mister. Like because maybe in the modern time that we can look in Instagram, there are so many celebgram. Just make a something. We can say viral.
Controversial.
Yes.
Like
to be a famous.
Like Nikita Mirzani, the queen of controversy.
Yeah. to be a famous. So maybe I think they are not thinking about education maybe.
Exactly.
For tech. Yes.
Now let's compare about the attitude of artists who, even though they are rich but doesn't have education, with artists who, even though they are rich but they decided to have education. Like my first example, let's compare Nikita Mirzani and also Maudy Ayunda or Cinta Laura. How do you think their attitude is different? How different is their attitude?
Nikita Mirzani, we actually we know that she has a bad attitude,
especially maybe about solving problem. Yeah.
Yes. Because I think for Nikita Mirzani, just thinking how can I get much money? I don't care. I must do something. But maybe for Maudy Ayunda. She is becoming an artist because maybe he likes acting, and then maybe because acting it's their hobby.
And there is opportunity also, of course.
Yes.
Okay. But let's see, for example, like Reza Arab. You know Reza Arab Octavian, right?
Yes, Mister.
Yeah, one of the member of Weird Genius. In the past, several years ago, Reza Arab is not the personal of Weird Genius. He was actually a YouTuber. You know that, right?
YouTuber, yes, Mister.
Who always played games. Games on YouTube. At that time, he was quite a little bit like Nikita Mirzani, right? Quite controversial. Because the way how he played game, have you ever seen that?
Yes.
How Reza Arab played game. So many of cursing and swearing and animals, right? Being said by Reza Arab. You know that, right?
Yes, Mister.
But that's somehow make most of young teenagers like to watch Reza Arab YouTube. But yeah, that's the way how Reza Arab somehow get a lot of subscriber because he keeps on, yeah, saying something stupid like that. But then after that, Reza Arab decided to quit from YouTube, and then he becomes, yes, he joined the musical industry, right, to build this group which is Weird Genius, and he somehow donated the YouTube channel that he has already established to this orphanage, right, if I'm mistaken. And all of the profit coming from that YouTube channel is being given to that orphanage. So from seeing that, We know that even though we know Reza Arab, he has a lot of tattoo, right? He has a lot of tattoo, and the way how he speak is pretty much the same like Nikita Mirzani, right? It so doesn't have any.
But
doesn't have
I
any.
I already read some article that Reza Arab have a bad attitude because he have some bad memories in the past with
his father.
Her family. Yes, her family. So this is one of the reason why Reza Arab have a bad attitude.
Bad attitude. All right. So yeah, we can see that whenever there is this problem, Nikita Mirzani and Reza Arab always solve it with hot hat. Never with cool hat, right? So that it's most of the time always end up with conflict with somebody else. And if in the case of Nikita Mirzani, most of the time the conflict always end up with Nikita Mirzani being jailed in prison, right?
Yes, mister.
No. But after we know that basically Reza Arab and also, you know what, not only Reza Arab, but also Nikita Mirzani, they also always donated most of their money to the orphanage.
But actually they are a good person.
Exactly. So from that alone, even though probably they are, of course, they are not educated, that somehow the reason on why they are, the way how they are speaking is kind of little bit uncivilized and a little bit barbaric, right? But deep within their heart, they're actually quite good persons because they also like to help other people, right? So yeah, that's maybe why we should not judge person from the cover, right? We have to see whether or not they're actually good. For example, do you know there is also one of this member of ministry in Indonesia? She actually also doesn't have higher education. Do you know who is she? Anybody know? One of the ministry of Indonesia.
I don't know.
Ibu Susi Pujiastuti.
Oh.
Right?
Menteri Kelautan.
Exactly. She was actually only graduated from junior high school. If I'm mistaken,
yes.
Right?
Because she is sick. She is sick. She have a serious.
Serious what?
Something wrong with her health.
Oh, so that's why she cannot join the education.
Yes, I already read article.
Yeah. So basically, even though she doesn't have any higher education, but she somehow can prove to all of people out there that she can be a big businesswoman, right? Big businesswoman with also good attitude, right? Good attitude, and even good English, good English, and all of the things that she is saying is actually somehow really, really high educated and so many. Of intellectual sentence, right? Intellectual words, even though she doesn't have like official high education in university. Maybe that's the same like what you have already said, that not all of the things we can learn it from schools or university. We can somehow learn it from the life itself. Life is probably like the best teacher. And somehow, Pujiastuti proved that. Life is her best teacher. And she learned a lot from life. Yes, that is it. One.
Because she is maybe a lucky person and then have a good opportunity and then he worked hard to get everything.
So as long as you have the willingness to work hard, even though you don't have the opportunity to have higher education, you can still become a success individual, right?
Yes,
like
Mr.
Pujiastuti or maybe like Raffi Ahmad. I mean, Raffi Ahmad, even though well, maybe you think that you just become an artist and an artist easy, or maybe an artist actually has already been handsome so that it's easy for him to become an artist. But to become an artist is not really that easy also, right? It demands your talent. Your talents also to become an actor, right? Like that. Because it is not easy, right? to acting in front of camera. It's not just because you are handsome or you're beautiful. You have to have the talent, right? And the skills to acting in front of camera. Not everyone become an artist, even though maybe they have already been handsome or beautiful at first. So yeah, it's also probably one of the reasons on why Raffi Ahmad also become one of the success individual. Even though there are also many handsome and beautiful individual out there, but maybe they're maybe not as rich as Raffi Ahmad, right? Because yeah, it's also come back again, the hard work of Raffi Ahmad. And
take advantage of the opportunity.
Exactly, because this kind of opportunity will not going to come to you twice, right?
Yes, mister.
So if you have the opportunity, take it. So that if you have really established your career, for example, and then if you have a lot of money, then you can, if you want to, move your education to higher level.
Yes,
and then choose any kind of a university that you want, world-class university with your own money. You want to go to Oxford, Harvard, Cambridge, or anything, you can pay it by your own money, right? okay. Maybe, hopefully someday you can become an artist. Or maybe you can.
Yes, I mean.
Or you can become a YouTuber also, maybe, probably. Even the. Like Atta Halilintar, he starts by becoming YouTuber first, right?
And yes, Mr.
After becoming a YouTuber, then he become an artist, right? Probably, even though you're going to take some years of time, but if you like consistent. So, do you have YouTube channel, by the way?
No.
Maybe someday in the future. Sasa, do you want to become YouTuber or artist?
Semuanya. All.
All. Maybe.
All artist, okay. All YouTuber.
Maybe. Or you just want to become a housewife. Ibu rumah tangga. Maybe. Okay, anyway, thank you all for sharing your opinion and sharing your thought. It is almost 9. I have another class again after this. Okay, so we continue it again tomorrow, yeah?
Okay, mister.
And see you guys.
Okay.
See you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good job.